What's going on, guys? Welcome back to Madden NFL 15, and here we are week 11 as the Chargers back at home to take on the Oakland Raiders. This is our first home game since week 5. We've been on the road for 6 straight weeks, and we're ready to give our home fans a show. Last week, we put the hurt on the Denver Broncos, 31 points in the first half, 31-0 lead in the first half. And then from there, it was okay. I threw 2 interceptions in the second half. We won the game 45-20. Roster pretty much the same for the Oakland Raiders, only one injury to a backup defensive tackle. And taking a look at the NFL standings, how could you not love what we're doing? Right behind us, the Seahawks. So will the Seahawks be in the Super Bowl? Or will it be the Cardinals or the Saints? The NFC is looking pretty weak in this series. Taking a look at the season stats across the league, I'm 3rd in passing behind Stafford and Glennon. So Mike Glennon put in work in this series as well. And I'm right ahead of Johnny Football, Johnny Manziel, by 2 yards. I'll probably do another stat update right before the playoffs begin, but right now we're focusing on the Raiders. So they're 1-8, we're 9-0. Will the Raiders upset us at home, or will we continue our win streak and move on to 10-0, creeping closer to an undefeated season? Let's find out. And it's been a while, so welcome back to Qualcomm Stadium here in San Diego, California. Home fans have been awaiting this game for quite some time, as this stadium has been empty since week 4. Looking at our upcoming schedule, Steelers, Dolphins, Bills, Eagles, and of course we have the Raiders, who are 1-8 today, as we're trying to take care of business and continue our undefeated season. Many experts not even giving the Oakland Raiders the benefit of scoring any points in this game, and we'll see what happens. As we come to the field here, 1st and 10 from the 20. After last week's performance in Denver where we couldn't get anything going on the ground, it's very important that we get the run established today. And there goes Bush up the middle for 6 yards. His longest carry going into the 4th quarter was 3 yards. So getting started with 6 here in this game is not a bad start at all. 2nd down and 4, dropping back, firing over the middle for Sudarius Small. That's caught for a 1st down, good for 4. And that'll get us down to the 31-yard line as this drive will continue. Play calling shouldn't be too difficult here against the Oakland Raiders as we carry up the middle with Bush once again. He gets near 1st down. That's good for 8 yards. And a 2-for-14 start for Bush in today's game. I like it. I'm not going to complain about it. 2nd down and 2 in the shotgun. Dropping back, firing for Teron Barr and Branch. Barr had the catch, and he was going to be down near midfield, but I'll bring up 3rd down and 2 as he dropped the catch. And I'm going to drop back here out of the shotgun once again. Fire outside for Baldwin, and Baldwin is refusing to go down. They can't bring him down. First it was Cromartie, and then some other guy came in and missed on the tackle. 1st and 10 from the 50 as I draw back once again. See no one open. Take off the run. Trying to get the 1st down. I have it, and I step out of bounds. I could have stayed in bounds, but that's good for 14 yards. That could have really gone the distance. And now we have 1st and 10 from the 36. Shotgun once again. Going outside quickly for Baldwin, and Baldwin getting stood up by Browner, but he refuses to go down. That's near 1st down. Good for 10. And that brings up 2nd down and inches. Someone please test Jonathan Baldwin for PEDs, because this dude is just beast down here right now. 3rd down and 3. Going to drop back, going outside for Teron Barr. And Barr actually held on to the pass this time as he was hit by Branch quickly after the catch was made. Coming to the field here, 5 wide. 1st down from the 16-yard line. No one open once again. Getting out of the pocket, running down the field, and diving for a 1st. And I dove because I thought I was going to get hit hard, but I could have easily taken that one in for the touchdown. Or maybe gotten pushed out of bounds inside the 5. But here we are, 1st down to go from the 5. Screen pass outside Sudarius Small as the Raiders brought a blitz. And this is getting out of control. We have run screens pretty effectively in the red zone for the past couple of games, and it is just working so well. Defenses are constantly bringing blitzes against our wider formations, and that was just, I don't know, it just worked so well. That easily could have gone for more yardage, but it's good for 5 yards and a score, and we're on the board first. And we'll come back on the field here at the 38 as Oakland does not score, so we have a chance to increase our lead as we'll go to Bush here on the ground, and that one's only good for 3 yards, tackled by Hightower. 3 carries, 17 yards, not a bad start for Bush. It's definitely better than last week where he was like 3 for maybe 4 yards. But here I go, taking off the run, and I'm going to get stripped, and the ball will come loose. I was trying to get upfield, and I got stuck. And now Oakland has the ball at the 43-yard line, trying to tie the game up, but our defense holds, and we have the ball back at the 20. Dropping back here as the Raiders bring a blitz, and that one is caught in traffic by, I believe that was Jonathan Baldwin. Nice catch once again. Probably could have gone to the outside, but here we go, 2nd down and 5. as the first quarter is still winding down. Screen set up for Bush, but I'm going over the middle for Baldwin, and he actually held onto the football this time. If you remember a couple games ago against Kansas City, I believe it was, we tried to run that same play twice, and Baldwin dropped that same catch twice in the red zone. It was frustrating, but there goes Jonathan Baldwin getting his groove back. First down and 10 as I'm taking off the run, and I'm going to get near the 40-yard line. I tried to slide there, but it wouldn't let me. But I've got four carries for 41 yards. Of course, I do have the fumble, the turnover, which isn't great. But things tend to happen like that when you're a mobile quarterback. So here we go, second down and 7, and I'm trying to get out of the pocket because my pocket was collapsing on that play-action rollout. But unfortunately, I'm sacked on the play by Khalil Mack. Ends up not really losing any yards. So here we go, 3rd and 7, last play of the first quarter as they'll bring pressure, and this one's thrown outside for Small, and that is how we'll end the first quarter as we have a first down at the 28-yard line. This ball is still moving down the field, and we'll look to increase our lead here in the second quarter as our offense is pretty much having its way right now with the Oakland Raiders. We can run, we can throw. Unfortunately, I got sacked on that previous play or the play before that play, but here we go, 2nd and 6. As the Raiders looking to be bringing pressure once again from the safety. No one over the top, so we'll see if I can find someone open. And I'm going to drop back, throwing this one, threading the needle to Teron Barr. That ball got thrown in the triple coverage, and Barr came down with it, taking risk and making plays. Second and goal from the 11, read option, getting away from Branch, and I can't get past Cromartie. I should have lowered the shoulder because my break tackle rating is actually pretty decent for a quarterback. But here we go, 3rd down and goal from the 5. And the Raiders will drop everyone back in coverage, but they're not protecting the flats as Jonathan Baldwin sidesteps Cromartie, and he's in the end zone for the touchdown. Jonathan Baldwin's having a pretty surprisingly good game here in the first half as he's kind of been kind of that go-to guy when everyone else is pretty much covered, which he's kind of had an issue with in previous games. But now we're at 14-0 as our lead is trying to increase here against the Raiders. No score here from Oakland. Ball at the 22-yard line starting on our next drive. 2nd and 7. And I'm going to drop back once again. Fire quickly on the slant for Small. And Cromartie was just tripping. I don't know what he was doing, but that could have gone all the way for a score. 1st and 10 here. Hand off for Bush. Trying to get to the outside as he's wrapped up. After gaining about 6 yards. 6 carries for 29 yards for Bush. Not a bad start. 3rd down and 5 here from the 40. And we're going to go shotgun here once again. Going to drop back, fire quickly inside for Small. He's got the grab. He's brought down by Hightower. But that's good for a first down. And I've got to stop throwing my receivers into coverage like that. It's going to get someone injured eventually. 1st and 10 here inside of 4 minutes as the Raiders are playing everyone deep. And I'm going to run and get brought down just shy of the first down. Brought down by Hightower. He is all over the place. But here we go, 2nd down and 1. Baldwin in motion. Hand off up the middle for Bush. And look at Bush creating some room. 7 carries, 36 yards here in the first half. I like it. I'm loving the effort here on the offensive line. 1st down and goals. I'm going to roll out of the pocket. Get it off to Mark Sharp. He's got a 1st down. And he is still in bounds. So the clock will continue to roll here as we're approaching the 2-minute warning. 2nd and 10 from the 26-yard line. Going play action, and I am ripped down as that did not go the way I wanted it to. Howard just ran right up the middle, and no one accounted for him. 2-minute warning just hit as we have a 3rd and 17 from the 33-yard line. As I'm going to drop back, and this pass thrown incomplete as I was hit. I was trying to go to the flat just in the last second because no one was open on those corner routes. But here goes Gostkowski, and this one's going to be from 50 yards out from the right hash, and this one's up, and Gostkowski nails it. And we have a 17-0 lead here. This probably will take us into halftime. But we get the ball back here 30 seconds later. The Raiders are not taking care of the football. As we'll go play action here once again. Rolling out of the pocket. Going to fire late for Lewis. Nice tippy-toe grab on the sideline. Getting us down to the 41. Stops the clock there with 1:19. Drive back once again. Firing inside for Blackman. That one caught. And that will keep the clock running here. So we'll actually go with a no huddle. Trying to get everyone back to the line here as soon as possible. Closing on in a minute here in the first half. I'm going to drop back once again, throwing over the middle for Small. And a nice spin move by Small as he got the 1st down. And we'll call a timeout here, 2nd and 10, as we have 50 seconds left. And going deep down the field for Small as he's got us inside the 10-yard line down to the 9. The play-action rollout. If your tight end's not open, you got to look for your secondary option. That was actually Teron Barr. That's my mistake. That was Barr with the reception. As we have 3rd and goal here from the 11. As we have 15 seconds left, and I'll drop back once again. And they bring pressure, and I'm nearly brought down for the sack. But we'll just settle for the field goal here at the end of the half. to put us up 20-0 in the first half. 12 seconds left. Gostkowski from 28 yards out. This one's up, and no doubt about it, that one right up the middle. And we'll take a 20-0 lead here at halftime. Back on the field as Oakland opens up the third quarter with a touchdown. Up by 13. We got to get back to business here on offense. Going to get out of the pocket here and try to pick up the first down. Sliding is not working in this game for some reason as I pick up a couple yards there. And that brings up second down and 4. Going 5 wide. Looking for the quick pass to the outside to Teron Barr. Caught for a first down. He's pushed out of bounds by Browner at the 44. That's what we want to do here. Quick passes. Oakland is bringing a lot of blitzes here in the game. We don't have time to look for those deep passes down the field. And they'll bring pressure once again. Looking over the middle. That one caught by Baldwin. First down reception. And Jonathan Baldwin having a pretty decent game here. This first half for him has been pretty solid with the touchdown. You know, the number of receptions he's having, getting open in space. And here we go on 3rd down and 8. Trying to get the first down. And Rashad Swope. They left them open. They weren't protecting the flats once again. And Swope with the first down. Didn't have to go for it on 4th. 2 minutes left here in the third, sending everyone deep down the field, and no one open, so I'm going to try to buy some time and find Lewis, and Lewis getting down inside the 5-yard line, down to the 4. This is what elite quarterbacks do, buy some time. I easily could have taken off the run there, but I was a little worried about getting hit, so I'm glad. I'm ecstatic that Lewis got open there on that play. As we had a screen set up, we're going to switch out of it, drop back, looking for a receiver over the middle, and that's going to be Brown with his first career catch. And his first career touchdown. The audible was a pretty smart move. The Oakland Raiders brought both safeties on the blitz. Branch was on the blitz. Jenkins was on the blitz. And going to the screen would have ended up probably in a loss of a couple yards because they were pressing. And it's kind of hard to run those screen plays when they're pressing. And now we have a 26-7 lead here with a little bit of time left in the third. As I'm going to throw late for Lewis. And Lewis, ooh, with the nice sideline grab for the first down. And that was a pretty nice one to see. You see Lewis fully extend here. This was a beautiful grab by a tight end. Not a receiver, a tight end. This guy's got some pretty good skills. I'm glad we picked him up. 2nd down and 6. We'll go play action here. Going to roll out of the pocket, try to find someone open. Thought about dumping it off to Lewis, but I'm going to find Ertz open late. And Ertz with 11 yards, and that's good enough for a first. Ball at the 30-yard line, going back to Bush on the ground. Why can't Bush just run straight up the field? Why are you zigzagging? But he picks up a couple yards there. Good for 9. I'm not going to complain. But just run straight. Don't run into people. Just run straight up the field. And you've got a first down. 2nd down and 1 here. Setting up the screen to Bush. Bush has the reception. And Bush has room to run. But he's going to get brought down and pushed out of bounds at the 14-yard line. Those blocks up the field on the screen were atrocious. And that allowed those Oakland defenders to get through. As we're in the shotgun here, 1st and 10 from the 14. Going to drop back, looking for a ball within the end zone. And it's thrown behind him just slightly, and he's down at the 1. Oh, boy, that one nearly got in the end zone for a touchdown. But here we are, 1st and goal from the 1-yard line, and we'll bust out the screen. I probably could have just given the ball to Bush, but Sedarius Small with his 2nd touchdown receiving of the game. I'm a little selfish. I prefer Sedarius Small. He's got speed. He's got pretty decent height. He's not the tallest receiver. Jonathan Baldwin is, I believe, our tallest receiver at 6'4", but Sedarius Small has that speed. He's a rookie, and I want to, you know, I'm going to get him up there for best wide receiver. He's easily the best receiver we have, but here we go back on the ground with Bush up 33-7, and Bush is just continuing to run the football well here in the game. 11 carries for 61 yards. Going to drop back here, 1st and 10 from the 37, and this is going to end up as a sack. I had Lewis and also Mark Sharp open in the flats, didn't see him. And now we have a 2nd and 19 from the 46-yard line. Going to try to get the first down here. Eventually, that's good for 13 yards there to Sedarius Small as I pass 30 yards passing. And now we have a 3rd and 6 from the 33. So there's a chance here for a field goal, but we like to pick up the first down. As I'm going to drop back, fire for Jonathan Baldwin. And Baldwin is continuing to end up clutch here in the game as he has so far in the game had 8 catches, 82 yards, and of course the touchdown. Inside of 4 minutes here, ball at the 24-yard line as we go 5 wide once again. Going to drop back, try to find someone open, and that's going to be Sedarius Small, who I overthrew. I don't know how I did that. If I hit him in stride, that's a touchdown, no safety over the top. That's a routine drop back and throw, and I just missed. I don't know how I did that, but unfortunately I did, and now we have 3rd and 10. As I go outside for Jonathan Baldwin once again, and Baldwin with another catch, getting us a first down, and he's got to be close to 100 yards here in the game, as last time we checked, he was at 82. And let's go ahead and feed Bush here in the red zone. Handoff up the middle. He's got close to a first down as he's going to get us down to the 4-yard line, bringing up third down and one. And we'll go I formation. Handoff Bush up the middle. Why are you bouncing it to the outside? Run forward, and we're stopped just short. Fourth and one at the 3-yard line. I don't know what Bush was doing on the play. Just run the ball up the middle. Follow your blocks. And we actually end up settling for the field goal there as we win this game 36-7. There was a part of me that wanted to go for it on fourth down and one, but I was like, let's just kick the field goal. Maybe we get the ball back for one more drive. But fortunately for the Raiders, we did not get the ball back. They end up running out the clock as we win 36-7 and complete the sweep of the Raiders. Only one more AFC West game remaining against Denver in week 17, but for right now, the Chargers are 10-0. Nice game here running the ball. I mean, we did a pretty solid job in the game running, passing, only one turnover via my fumble, but everything else just went pretty well in today's game. Actually, not pretty well. Everything else went exceptionally well. Brown got his first touchdown of the season. Sarius Small had two off of screens. I would like to kind of switch out of running screens as often as I do, but I can't really do anything about that. It's just the way the offense works. And checking out my stats on the game, 38 of 51, 338 yards. That's a pretty nice stat line right there. Four touchdowns and no interceptions. Last week against Denver, I threw two, so that kind of helps out a little bit. So that's seven touchdowns, two interceptions. I'll take it. On the ground this week, Reggie Bush, 16 carries, 77 yards, could have had a touchdown, but unfortunately, he just didn't win hard enough. And on the ground, 10 carries for myself and 81 yards. Not going to complain about that. Through the air, it was Sedarius Small, 10 catches, 62 yards, two touchdowns. Jonathan Baldwin, 9 for 94, nearly at 100 yards, but he had one touchdown in the game. Teron Barr, 6 for 63. Mercedes Lewis, 4 for 65. Justin Blackman, 2 for 12. Reggie Bush, 2 for 6. Zach Ertz, 1 for 11. Marlon Brown, 1 for 4. Actually, Marlon Brown's not a rookie. I assumed he was a rookie, but he's not. Rashad Swope, 1 catch, 11 yards. He's actually the tallest receiver on the team at 6'6". Mark Sharp was 1 for 11, and Dexter McCluster had a busted up screen. That was for a loss of one. Giuseppe Williams on the game. Another bad game against our defense. 13 to 23 for 124 yards. One touchdown, one interception. His longest pass on the game was 28 yards, so not too bad. On the ground, Matt Forte still without a touchdown this season. He was 14 for 53. No Sean Marino was 7 for 19. I actually might trade for Matt Forte. I don't know. I'm picking up a running back manually in the offseason. I have no idea who it's going to be. It really depends. If we don't pick up a rookie in the offseason that's going to be consistent, then I might actually have to end up trading for someone manually. Let me know what you guys think about that in the comment section below. Let me know also who you think I should pick up. I have to pick up someone that is not in the middle of a huge contract, so maybe someone with like 1 or 2 years left on their contract, so that way our cap space isn't getting destroyed. And look at our third down conversion. We had 15 on the game, but we converted 11 of them. And unfortunately, we missed out on a two-point conversion. I forgot to put that in here, but we missed out on one as we were 6-for-6 in the red zone with 4 touchdowns and 2 field goals. And time of possession in this game was absolutely horrid. 31 for us and only 8 minutes for the Oakland Raiders. But like I was saying, let me know what you guys think about me manually acquiring a better running back than Reggie Bush and also Dexter McCluster. I don't think he's going to work out either. I'll probably at the end of the season show you guys a list of available running backs that have 1 or 2 years left on their contract who aren't that high in salary space or won't be that high in salary space. Or maybe I'll just wait until after the draft and see what we do at running back. So week 11's done, and up next in week 12 we have the 2-8 Pittsburgh Steelers. No Big Ben, free agent. Their starting quarterback, I believe, is someone that is recently new. He's like a second-string quarterback or a second-year quarterback. And I end up grabbing AFC Offensive Player of the Week for Week 11 after that performance. Not a bad game. 4 touchdowns. I had 300 yards passing, 80 on the ground. Not a bad game. And this is going to be a Thanksgiving game between the Steelers and the Chargers at home. And like I did in the last Strong Safety episode, let's take a look at the MVP awards so far this season. So far, I'm number one, backed up by Stafford, Manziel, Kaepernick, Bortles, Dysart, Russell Wilson, Andy Dalton, Rockford Stokes of the Saints, and then Matt Ryan on this list as well. That's a matchup that I want to see. I want to see us go against the Browns in the AFC Championship game. Me versus Manziel, everything on the line. Everyone's trying to get that Super Bowl, get into the Super Bowl, and it's going to be hopefully between myself and Manziel. That would be awesome. But who knows? It could be Denver, because we're most likely going to end up winning the division. So Denver is most likely going to have a wild card spot, or they're going to have a wild card spot. which means that, you know, maybe, or maybe they don't make it through the wild card. Maybe they get dropped. But they're not going to win the division, so, obviously, that's the way things go. Offensive Player of the Year, I'm leading. And on Defensive Player of the Year, Donald Butler, one of our players on defense, is leading this as well. So the Chargers bringing home a lot of hardware this season. Offensive Rookie of the Year, leading this as well. Sadarius Small in third place for Offensive Rookie of the Year. That's not bad at all. He was also up there for... Oh, Mark Sharp's on this as well. Wow, Mark Sharp, the fullback. This guy hardly gets any rushing yards or receiving. I don't know how he's on this list. Defensive Rookie of the Year led by Israel Howard. He sacked me twice in this last game. And we're just going to fly through here. Best quarterback, I'm leading this as well. Manziel right behind me in the AFC. Bortles, Dalton, Dysart, Middlebrooks, Romel Strong of the Steelers, Alex Smith of the Chiefs, Drew Brees, and then Geno Smith of the Buffalo Bills. Best running back, of course, Reggie Bush is all the way at the bottom. Really shouldn't be on here at all, but he's not having a terrible season. And look at the Patriots in this series. 3-7. A lot of familiar names here for AFC best wide receiver. And look at Sadarius Small in there at number 6. Ahead of Sammy Watkins. And Steve Smith is still playing. Wow, I did not know that. Best offensive line. There better not be a single Charger on here. And unfortunately, there is one. Andy Levitre, my right tackle, I believe, is on this list. I don't know how this guy is probably... Actually, you know what? No, he's not the worst. My center's terrible, and my left guard. This guy is just killing me every game. Best defensive line, another Charger on here, Oliver Vernon. And then Khalil Mack all the way down here at number 10 for best defensive line, although he gets a lot of sacks. Best defensive back in the AFC, no Chris Harris Jr., so people don't have to worry about me saying his name incorrectly. And then Steven Gostkowski, best kicker, should be clearly, because I think he's only missed one field goal this entire season. And looking at the NFC, best offensive player, Matt Stafford, Adrian Peterson, Kaepernick, LeSean McCoy, Rockford Stokes, Calvin Johnson, Carlos Hyde, Matt Ryan, Russell Wilson, and then Marshawn Lynch, beast mode. Best defensive player, Luke Kuechly, Bobby Wagner, Prince Shimbo, Max Bullo, Jarius Bird of the Saints, Navarro Bowman, Darrell Washington, Chris Culliver, Earl Thomas, and then Paul Poslunski, I believe. I don't even know. Offensive Rookie of the Year, Wesley Hall, receiver for the Detroit Lions, Peppers, Julian Morales is a Cardinal. I believe he's a Detroit Lion in my strong safety series. It's kind of interesting to see how these drafts differ by series. Looking at best defensive rookie of the year, Sasha Morgan of the Bears, Marshall Arnold of the Panthers. Grant Frazier is on this list. He would be starting in Tampa Bay in my strong safety series if I wasn't drafted there, if I didn't place myself on Tampa Bay. He would be the starter because they really didn't have anybody at strong safety. Best quarterback, Matt Stafford, Colin Kaepernick, Russell Wilson, Matt Ryan, Rockford Stokes, Aaron Rodgers down at 6, Mike Glennon. Adrian Peterson for best running back, LeSean McCoy, Carlos Hyde, Marshawn Lynch. Doug Martin is having a pretty solid season, although the Buccaneers are 5-5. And Mike Evans at number 3 on this list for best wide receiver behind Calvin Johnson and Martin of the Lions. So maybe Mike Evans has touchdowns here in this series because he has no touchdowns through all the games I recorded on the strong safety side, which is quite annoying. So maybe it might be a little harder for us to pick up Mike Evans in the offseason. That's definitely someone that I want to pick up. I would easily trade Justin Blackmon and maybe one of our backup receivers, Rashad Swope. Teron Barr I might keep because I kind of like the guy, but I might ship him off to Tampa Bay if it means that it kind of makes more sense for the series. Because I don't want to just rip Tampa Bay off with a trade. I want to kind of make it interesting. We might have to throw in a draft pick as well. And best kicker in the NFC, Graham Gano, Blair Walsh, Mason Crosby, Nick Folk of the Saints, Chandler Catanzaro of the Eagles. So that'll pretty much do it here for week 11. Up next, week 12 against the Pittsburgh Steelers, as this season is almost done. I'm trying to wrap up this rookie season as quick as possible so we can get into season 2 and have a lot of fun in the offseason. Hope you guys enjoyed, and as always, enjoy your evening. See you guys later.